On March the 23rd, a video emerged showing the Damascus government forces conduct a strike on Hayat Tahrir al-Sham, HTS. The shelling targeted the terrorist fortifications and depots. MSM, in conjunction with various Western-backed organizations, such as the International Rescue Committee, shifted the story and claimed that a civilian hospital had been struck. As such, the narrative is this: the bloody Assad regime is back at it, targeting civilians and killing its own people. As might be expected, this media campaign is part of the attempts by the US to rebrand HTS as a former terrorist and now reformed organization in order to have another ally in a different part of Syria. The Damascus government recent punishment of HTS and the Turkish-backed militants in northeastern Syria is happening with Russian support and is part of a wider push to liberate more areas of Syria. Ankara is dissatisfied with this, even summoning the Russian ambassador to complain about the severe strikes that Moscow had carried out on terrorist targets. The Turkish side insists that artillery and airstrikes on positions and infrastructure of Turkish-funded terrorists in Greater Idlib violated the de-escalation agreement. No mentions were made of the violations that are frequently carried out by these same terrorists. Turkey would like to continue to enjoy the smuggled oil it used to receive from the US-backed Syrian Democratic Forces. The United States still benefits from that smuggled oil. On March the 23rd, a convoy of more than 300 tankers left Syria's Hazakah region and entered Iraq. Washington's oil repatriation is not proceeding without a hitch either. On March the 23rd, several rockets hit a US military base near the Conoco oil field in the Syrian province of Deir Ezzor. Lebanon's Al Mayadeen TV reported that the US suffered casualties. Little else is known.